Hello from ChemHelp ASAP. We're going to go over three somewhat problematic Lewis dot structures, the structures of sulfuric acid, phosphoric acid, and nitric acid. Now, these three structures are problematic because they violate our typical guidelines for Lewis structures. And our guidelines are, one, we want to satisfy the octet rule, two, we want to minimize formal charge, and three, if we have a charge, we want to place it on as reasonable of an atom as possible. So let's look at sulfuric acid, H2SO4. Sulfuric acid, I'm simply going to go straight to the Lewis structure. Sulfuric acid, because it contains sulfur, which is a third row element, sulfur can violate the octet rule. And this is how sulfuric acid is most commonly written. Note that we have more than 8 electrons around sulfur. We have 6 bonds. That's 12 electrons around sulfur. And normally you'd say, no way. But for sulfur, it's okay. So the octet rule does apply, but it doesn't apply to sulfur in particular because it is a third row element. And that's fine. What's our second molecule? Phosphoric acid. Phosphoric acid is very much like sulfuric acid. We have phosphorus. It is a third row element. Let's get the bond in there. And we'll add our lone pairs. All the oxygens are clustered around the phosphorus. And we actually have 5 bonds to phosphorus. That's 10 electrons. Violates the octet rule, but that's fine. It's not violating anything because the octet rule truly only applies to second row elements. Finally, let's do nitric acid. This is the Lewis structure for nitric acid. Now, what's difficult about nitric acid is not that it violates the octet rule, because it can't, because these are all second row elements. It's that we can't draw it without having formal charges. And so we draw our charges plus minus, and we circle them to indicate there are charges on our atom. But almost always when we draw molecules with second row elements, we will be able to not show formal charges in our atoms. For nitric acid, we have to show them. So that makes nitric acid feel weird. It may feel like you're drawing it incorrectly, but actually you're doing just fine. You'll have to put formal charges. So these are three structures that are sort of outliers that require us to either violate octets or have formal charges. I would recommend memorizing these structures. I'm not a fan of memorization, but these are just three common outliers, so just get comfortable with these. Everything else in organic chemistry, for the most part, will follow our traditional guidelines and rules for drawing Lewis dot structures.